Hello everyone, welcome to day 17 of the 60 day adding value challenge. So I'm Eddie the Bone Setter. So today I'm going to share more about shoulder stretches, especially for those who are having frozen shoulder, feeling shoulder pain, or they're having difficulty on lifting up their hands and up like this. So what are we going to do? Let's check it out. So how are we going to do this stretch today? So we need a simple wall, just a little bit gap here. Now, let's say for those of you who are having frozen shoulder especially, you cannot lift up your hand, you cannot lift up your hand at least around more than 6 months, then here is a little bit tightened up already. So what you can do to stretch yourself, it looks very simple, but you need to really, really focus on it, okay? First thing first, you cannot lift up. So what you can do is, you lift up to where as high as you can. Okay, then let's say example is over here, okay? So now, when you lift up, a lot of people, they tend to have their body bent to back like this, which I don't recommend you doing. That is not a right way to stretch. That is more doing on your back, maybe later strain on your back. So later, lower back no problem, become lower back no problem. So here, when you stretch your shoulder, what I want you to do is that make sure you relax your shoulder. As you go on, sometimes we stiff up. We feel pain, don't worry. Stay there, stop. The height doesn't matter. What matters is actually you stretching on this muscle. So what I need to do is just simple as just... See, breathing. Slowly you let go and let go and let go. When the moment when you let go, you see the shoulder starts to relax already. Then only you slowly go up a little bit by a little bit. Then up, stuck already. Don't worry, just relax and just breathe in. And then out. Then breathe in. And then out. Okay, and breathe in. And then out. So once you slowly relax already, then only you go up. Okay, slowly by slowly you reach up as high as you can. Until you're high already, then you feel like suddenly you want to stiffen up, then stay there again, the same way again. Okay? So now, when you reach up to here already, and then if you want to make it much more harder a bit for you to really stretch your frozen shoulder, normally last time when we used to teach is like this, go up. But I found out sometimes they would cheat their shoulders. So what I would normally recommend them now to do is to go up here straight, and then slowly lift your hand like this, and your body try to turn. Okay, as you're turning, you're actually stretching over here. So what you can do is that slowly you turn, and just leave it there, stay there, don't worry, man. Just slowly relax, like just now it's like tighten up already, then you slowly let go. I know it's painful, but if it's too pain, you can let go a bit and then you relax. Once you relax, then you slowly turn out. Muscles are like this. You need to slowly practice and slowly communicate with it. Okay? So, slowly turn. But sometimes your elbow is bent. Try not to bend. I would recommend you try to be straight. But of course, if like you can go up higher, bend a little bit, it's okay. Don't need to be so perfect. And then turn, at least you feel the stretch here. Once you feel the stretch, slowly if you want to, you feel relaxed a little bit, then you can slowly add the stretch through your whole arm. Okay, these are all step-by-step lesson. Even me, if I lift up my head like that also, I feel my hand numb. So don't worry. If your hand numb, don't worry, it's normal. Because you are when you're against your hand, it's when going down, it's easy to blood flow because of gravity. If up, then the gravity pulls down. That's why you feel your hand a little bit numb, even like myself also. So do this for how long? Do it for 4 times per day. Hold it there for how long? Roughly around 30 seconds to 1 minute. So every single 10 seconds, 20 seconds, try to relax your shoulder and relax. Slowly you stretch. Once you stretch already, every day you get used to it until that level. If possible, when you reach to that level, try to put a pencil and draw. Because sometimes, most of the time, people thought, hey, I was this high, but actually it's not that high. If you can always reach the same height, slowly you can go above. A lot of times, we humans like to cheat ourselves. So you can do this way to make sure you check yourself whether you're doing right, okay? So this will be for those who are having frozen shoulder. So I hope it helps. And but it takes time. Don't worry. Just be patient. Like my dad, it took around 6 months. I'm honestly speaking, 6 months. So even I have to be with him because he was so severe until he cannot. He's just like that only. It's the severe one, the most severe in when we treat frozen shoulder. So it's possible to heal, just that it takes a little bit time. Okay. So I hope it helps. This is what you can do for yourself at home once this one stretched already. And also for those of you who haven't had treatment before with us, if you want to really have a very good result treatment with us, do this first. This is what it does is that when it stretched, it slowly starts to loosen up. The time when we tend to push in, it will be much more easier for us to push in. But sometimes some cases whereby they need to do first, then they can stretch easier. So, but no worries. At least this one you can try for yourself at home. Again, since now coronavirus, everybody is at home. These are the things that you can use your time efficiently for yourself. So I'm Eddie the Bone Setter. If you like this video, do give it a thumbs up. And also be sure to subscribe and turn on the bell icon. Also, comment down below on what you think and how did you feel if you're doing this for this exercise. And for those of you who are also having a lot of shoulder stiffness, yeah, you can also add this to your routine, not only the neck, okay? So I hope it helps. I'll see you tomorrow. Bye-bye. We'll be right back.